Shinname Nan Hailach Bera. Mór Mahlor Me the Rokku Pullen Kroga. Mór Manaig Mahlan Hin Doyila Mahir. Misha Era Uigni Me Nan Hailach Bera.
Welcome today to the 100th anniversary for Oglach volunteer Seamus Blaney. Before we start the proceedings today, I just ask you to keep in your thoughts and prayers Pat Joe Travers, who's ill in hospital at the minute. We'll start today then with the laying of the wreaths, and first we have Ronan O'Donnell for the Republican Movement. And on behalf of Thomas Russell Common, Kathy Roberts. And on behalf of the Blaney family, Liam Byrne.
Thank you.
We're delighted to welcome here today our guest speaker, West Belfast MLA Pat Sheehan, former POW and hunger striker. You're very welcome, Pat. Thank you.
Gormagov, our douche, but while I'm of wake as a goal, Lesh Nahagraha, as in Curry Lachak, August Lorchin Shaw, and you, Markomaru, Oglak, our Oglak Seamus Blaney, a fur boss, heart fan, Am Shaw, Kate Blaneyohan. I'd like first of all to thank the organisers for the invitation to come and speak here today on the occasion of the 100th anniversary of the death of Oglak Seamus Blaney. Speaking myself as someone who was an IRA volunteer, it's always a great honour and a privilege to be asked to speak at any event or commemoration for a comrade and fellow volunteer who made the ultimate sacrifice in the cause of Irish freedom. 100 years ago, Ireland was in turmoil. Partition had created two conservative reactionary states. And I think it's important to look back to that those days and give some political and historical context to Seamus Blaney's life and death and why he made the decisions he did. At the time of Seamus's death, Ireland was in the throes of the Civil War, a tragedy for the Irish nation. In the six counties, the non-unionist population was subjected to a brutal pogrom as the new northern state pursued a policy of Protestant supremacy and second-class citizenship for Irish nationalists. Republicans saw hopes of a free and socially just Ireland dashed. Thousands suffered imprisonment. 81 Republicans were executed officially in Free State prisons, and many more were murdered on the outside after being captured. Seamus Blaney had joined na Féinne Éireann when it was organised in Downpatrick and moved into the IRA in 1920. He lived through events of the previous few years, including the Easter Rising, the Tan War and the Treaty. And it wouldn't have been an easy decision for Seamus to join the army because he would have known he was putting his life and liberty at risk. And given what did happen to him and the price he paid, many will understandably want to know what it was that motivated Seamus Blaney. And I think the best answer to that question can be found in Bobby Sands' poem, The Rhythm of Time. There's an inner thing in everyone. Do you know this thing, my friend? It lies in the hearts of heroes dead. It screams in tyrants' eyes. It lights the dark of this prison cell. It thunders forth its might. It is the undauntable thought, my friend, the thought that says I'm right. And of course, Bobby was right when he wrote that, and Seamus Blaney was also right. But neither Seamus nor Bobby made the sacrifices they did just to prove they were right. They had a vision, a belief, an idea that their struggle, hardship, and sacrifice would lead to a better world for the rest of us. So who was Seamus Blaney? And why are we gathered here today in Dunfodrig to commemorate him 100 years after his death? Well, in May 1922, an active service unit from Downpatrick under the command of Willie Byrne was training in the Slieve na Griddle area. The unit was surrounded by British soldiers and B specials who opened fire on the ASU. Tommy Gracie was wounded in the leg and was captured along with Willie Byrne, Sam Cunningham, Max and Thomas Wallace, Harry McGee, Sean Perry, Seamus McCluskey, and of course Seamus Blaney. All nine were lined up on a lonely boreen with British soldiers lined up opposite them. Seamus had been a butcher's messenger and had regular access to the RUC barracks in Downpatrick. The RUC were obviously unaware of Seamus's membership of the army. In fact, he was actually the adjutant of the East Down Battalion of the Irish Republican Army and the quartermaster of his own unit. A detective inspector of the RUC who was with the British soldiers was so angered at discovering Seamus was an IRA volunteer that he ordered a soldier to shoot that bastard there. Seamus was shot in the head, and although he wasn't killed, his left arm was paralysed. All the other prisoners were given very severe beatings with rifles and revolvers. Seamus was taken to hospital while the others were taken to the old jail at the Mall, and the following day were remanded to Crumlin Road Jail in Belfast by Justice James Wolfe Flanagan. However, because his injuries were so serious, Seamus Blaney was kept in hospital. As a matter of interest, the day following the remand, Justice Flanagan was executed by the IRA in Newry as he left Mass. The volunteer who was supposed to carry out the operation took cold feet at the last minute, but a member of Cumann na mBan who was there to take away the weapon took the gun and shot the judge herself. While Seamus was still in hospital, the rest of the unit were sentenced to a year's imprisonment. But on June the 18th, two other volunteers entered the hospital and made good their escape with the wounded Seamus. The nurse in charge ran into the doctor's quarters where Dr. Robb lived with his family and exclaimed, "Doctor, the IRA have come. They are taking Blaney." To which the doctor coolly replied, "Make sure they pay the bill before they go." Barney McMullen and Dan Rice were driving Seamus away when the car broke down, and Seamus was forced to spend several rough nights hiding in fields where he was looked after by Ethna O'Donnell and her sister, who were members of Cumann na mBan. Eventually on July the 17th, Seamus was taken to a boat that had been commandeered by Joe Gilmore with the intention of getting him to the Free State. However, while passing the mouth of Carlingford Lock, the boat was intercepted and fired on by B Specials. Seamus was captured again, taken first to Kilkeel RUC Barracks, and was then moved to a military hospital in Belfast. Because of the sectarian attacks that were taking place in Belfast at that time, he didn't want anyone visiting him in the hospital, but he wrote many letters, especially to his mother and father. Unfortunately, Seamus's physical condition continued to deteriorate, and he was released after several months. Volunteer Seamus Blaney died at home on January the 18th, 1923, as a consequence of the injuries he received almost 8 months previously. Acarja, looking to the present and the future, it's often said there's nothing as powerful as an idea whose time has come. And it's thanks to the sacrifices of our patriot dead, not least among them, volunteer Seamus Blaney, that time has come now. By their heroism and sacrifice, they ensured the cause of Irish freedom endured and was sustained, and that now in 2023, we are closer than ever to undoing the injustice of partition and reuniting our country. The Orange State has gone. Unionist domination has gone. And we no longer need our young men and women to risk their lives and liberty on active service. The responsibility now rests with all of us to turn that idea for which Seamus died into a reality. It's up to us to create a new Irish national democracy, a new republic where the rights and identity of all our people of whatever persuasion and background will be accommodated and cherished. Irish unity will not just happen. We need to make it happen. Standing united and working together, if we all put our shoulders to the wheel, we can finish the job once and for all. That, Acarja, will be the only proper and fitting epitaph for Seamus Blaney. Janamish le Céile, eh? Let's do it together. That's the best way to show our respect for volunteers who sacrificed their lives in the course of the struggle. Acarja, there are traditions throughout the world, the Native Americans in particular, who believe that a person is never dead as long as their name is spoken. And that's something that Irish Republicans can identify. So today, at this memorial, 100 years after his death, we loudly and proudly speak the name of Volunteer Seamus Blaney. He was not and never will be just another statistic from a war many years ago. Seamus was a loving son and brother who was loved deeply by his family. He was a valued and highly regarded member of the local community. He was a friend and comrade to many. It is clear also that he was a committed and dedicated activist. While in hospital, he wrote to his father saying, "Father, the ideal Pierce died for, the same ideal McSweeney died for, that is what I was shot for. And as you see, there are many in Ireland still suffering for that ideal. And let us pray that all the people in Ireland will unite again, and then we will gain that ideal of freedom, which is dear to us all." Seamus Blaney was a brave and courageous volunteer of the Irish Republican Army. Far fear Croga of Eon, a fur bass or son Searshin a Hearn.
Garmila Mayogat Pat, for a very moving and fitting tribute to Seamus on his centenary. Before we close off with the national anthem, just want to thank the Colour Party, Nishi and Brian, who are really looking well with their historical nod to Seamus. It's very fitting. And also, as always, to the Common, who look after the monument so beautifully. And thank you all for attending today. Patrick's going to close us off with the national anthem.